What's happening, guys? Boss Sniper Beavetto bringing you a Final Fantasy 15 video. Today we're looking at how to get the brisket. A lot of people are having difficulties with this. There's two main reasons. One, the quest sends you to this random cafe and it's not entirely clear immediately why you're being sent there. The reason you're being sent there is to get a bounty quest and you need to take on this big guy right here. So you want the Marsh Madness Giant Awakens quest. Accept it and head out to the quest location. Now, second part that people struggle with is that when you're actually fighting this big guy, it doesn't actually seem to drop the brisket that you want very often at all. In fact, a lot of people just get the fangs. So we're just speeding up a little bit here, getting down to the quest point just to show you what to do. The reason is the beast in question is pretty big and players can only really hit the feet very easily. Sometimes you find yourself targeting the head as well. Neither one of these is going to drop the brisket. What you have to do is you've got to attack the flank or the side between the legs, and you've got to keep attacking it until it breaks and becomes scarred. So we'll meet again. I try to get a point warp on here and try and hit the flank, but it's not going to give me that location. So having faffed about for a little bit, give up and take ourselves down the side. But we might as well get some damage on the head while we're doing it. So simply attacking the feet isn't going to help. What you need to do is you need to move over to the side. So, get a target lock up here. On the PlayStation, you can use the R3 button to lock on. And then it's a case of doing some warp strikes up there. Now, you can see from the purple numbers, I'm not causing very much harm to it at this point. And using all these warp strikes is causing me to run out of MP and health as well, so worth having some elixirs with you while you're doing the fight. Make sure you can keep your magic points high. Now what I like to do, I like to use Ignis's Enhance ability, and this is going to make all my attacks be powered up with the particular beast individual weakness, so we're doing a little bit more damage here. Once again, can't seem to lock onto the flank from this location, so decided it was worth a try. Now, just going to speed it up a little bit here, guys, because basically there's nothing else to this fight other than point warping in and out of the beast. I think I found a weapon here. One of these Amiga weapons was doing a couple of hits in one go, so sometimes it is worth just experimenting around. Getting a few hits at a time in. And enhancements have worn off, so we'll just fire that back up again. So, that is it. Just keep pounding the flank. Now, at this point, it's fallen over. And what you'll see next time it stands back up again, you get a clear shot in a moment, you're going to see that it's actually now got some scarring around its sort of stomach and flank. You can see here, underneath the side, some pretty big scars. We've now done enough damage to get the brisket, which is what we're looking to do. And you don't have to keep on attacking the flank. I did for a little while. You don't have to keep on doing that. It's entirely optional at this point. And in a moment, I get quite lucky, and the big dude that you can summon shows up. And the fight's over in one hit when he arrives. Hope that was helpful, guys. Leave a like or a comment. Let me know what you thought. Thank you.